Home sales are predicted to spiral downward this year, of course, all because of the COVID-19 crisis. But what does that mean for prices at affordability? Ross is here with some projections tonight. Ross.
It's an economic forecast from RBC, which is predicting that the pandemic will be a temporary shock. According to the new report released this week, home sales are projected to dive nearly 30% to a 20-year low. Property prices are expected to fall briefly in the second half of the year, about 3%. And as for affordability, while it's improved, the Vancouver area is still the highest in the country, around 80%. That's the median pre-tax income needed to cover the cost of home ownership.
We're expecting a recession. We're expecting, at least a 1 or 2 month real kind of stoppage of activity. And for the housing market, that means, not a lot of face-to-face interactions and probably not a lot of sales the next few months. All that demand is really still there. We just need to get past this current kind of unusual situation.
RBC is predicting a 40% surge in housing sales next year, so that's the upside of this. As for prices, the BC Real Estate Association expects them to remain fairly stable since both supply and demand have dropped off.
Okay, Ross, there's been a lot of concern over food prices as we have seen many store shelves empty. They've been clear of many products, so all sorts of different products, and they are in short supply. So what are you learning about that?
Well, the hoarding hasn't helped. It hasn't helped calm nerves about this either. The empty shelves, lineups, runs on yeast and toilet paper. Canadians are wondering if the supply chain is sturdy enough to weather the COVID disruption. Despite some hoarding, though, a new report predicts our grocery bills won't go up by more than 4% this year, and that's no change from previous predictions. Meat prices are predicted to increase about 6%, and because of the low dollar, produce is expected to cost a bit more. Grocery stores are under a lot of pressure right now to keep shelves stocked and to ensure their customers are safe.
If the world runs out of food, the last country to run out of food is probably going to be Canada. And you can't quote me on that. We got plenty of food.
However, that could change next year when we get a better picture just how long and how much this virus will disrupt our lives, jobs, and the economy.
All right, some good news there, I suppose, when it comes to Canada's food supply. What kind of an impact have these restaurant closures had, though, because we've seen so many of those?
Yeah, that's the unfortunate part of this story, a huge impact. Restaurants make up 40% of the food sector, and that's now vanished, except some takeout and delivery. And experts predict that menu prices, although they may drop when restaurants reopen, many restaurants may not survive this.
All right, thanks very much for that, Ross.